Hi everybody, Steven here. If you ever wonder what adaptive quorum is in your vSAN cluster, or simply put, how many components can I tolerate failures from in a stretched or two-node cluster? Well, that's what we're going to talk about. See you in a bit. Everybody, thanks for sticking around. So what we're going to talk about is this thing called adaptive quorum in your vSAN cluster. It's more specific to your two node and to your stretched vSAN clusters. Now, before I jump right into it, I've got a little bit of, this shouldn't be that long, but I got a little demo and a little bit of a lecture here. But before I jump into it, hey, if you haven't subscribed to the channel and this is stuff that you like, please support the channel by clicking on that subscribe button. It's free. Just click on that, right? Also, another way to support it is with super thanks, but that's totally up to you. And for those of you that already support the channel and done super thanks, two thumbs up to you. Really appreciate it. Also, liking the video does also help with the YouTube analytics. Anyways, enough of that. Let's jump into this. Let's talk about what this thing called adaptive quorum is. Now, what adaptive quorum is. Now, hopefully you've seen my videos on the two-node cluster or stretch clusters. If not, I'll leave links for that towards the end. In a two-node cluster or a stretch cluster, obviously we could lose a whole site and still maintain availability, right? That's the whole point. But the question comes in, can I lose the site and lose a witness and lose other components as well and still continue to function? That's the million-dollar question, and I'm going to show you this, and the answer is kind of yes and no, and I'll kind of show you one of the things you really need to be aware of that I've kind of discovered, and you'll see that towards the end, okay? So you got to stick around for that. So let's take a look at this thing. All right. So in my example here, I've got a stretch cluster. So here I got site one, I got site two, I got three hosts in each site. And I've got a site for my witness, okay? Now, and here's my stretch cluster. Notice over here in my picture, I have a VM running. Right now, I've got the policy, the storage policy that's set up for it is site mirroring, and it's failure to tolerate equals one. So basically, failure to tolerate equals one, you're going to take your VM and you're going to mirror it, and then you got a witness component. So that's what we see over here. We have a mirror component. We have one component. Let's say the VM is 200 gigs in size. So this will be 200 gigs. Then there's a mirror of that, which is 200 gigs. And then there's a witness component of that over on site two here. Then because we're doing site mirroring, we're going to take that and mirror it across here. So again, we'll have a 200 gig component here, a 200 gig component here, and another witness component. So again, this VM, 200 gigs in size, is taking up 2, 4, 6, 800 gigs of storage. Okay. And then we have our witness appliance in the middle. Great, no problems. That kind of makes sense. Now, when we lose a device, let's say this device here dies or the witness dies or something like that, and we need to restart the VM, how do we know that we're allowed to? How do we know that we have enough valid components that survived failures in order to turn to power on the VM? And this is where this thing called votes come into play. You need to go into the command line to see these things. But in this example, each component here in this example has one vote each. Oops. You'll see that. And this witness component actually has three. So we have one, two, three, one, two, three. That's a total of six. And there's a total of nine. So we have nine. So in order to maintain quorum, we have to have at least more than half of that. So we can lose a bunch of components as long as we maintain five votes, we're able to power on the VM. Anything less than that, we're not able to power on the VM. So for example, if right now, if let's say, let's just say for argument's sake, this witness dies, okay? Everything would still continue to function. This VM doesn't get impacted by it, right? But let's say this whole site died on me. This VM here is gone. How many components do we have left over? We have one, two, three components, three volts left over, three out of a total of nine. We're not allowed to power it on, okay? So you see how this could come into play here. So let's take a look. Let's take a look at my lab environment, okay? And let's see what kind of happens underneath the covers, all right? So let me just go into my screen over here. All right. So let me just go full screen. So you'll see I actually got a cluster. I'm basing it on the original storage architecture. The Express storage architecture is very similar in nature, but I'm just going to keep this one simple for now. You'll see my stretch cluster has six ESXi hosts. I have a VM over here. This VM is running on host six. You can kind of see this over on the right here. Okay. This VM, again, just basically has the poly. If I actually go to here, monitor, if I go into physical displacement, you'll actually see, again, I've got my hard drive. Let's minimize that. I've got my swap object for the VM, and I got the home directory for the VM. Let's just look at the hard drive, okay? Just keep things simple. Let's minimize this. So you'll see I've got a component on host 5, a component on host 6. So there's my two RAID 1 components. And then when I look over here, there's a witness component on host 4. So hosts 4, 5, and 6 are in one site. Okay. That actually, if I go into, let's just show you, let's go into my vSAN, go into configure, and where is my fault domains? You'll see over here, I've got a fault domain called Toronto with hosts 1, 2, and 3. And I got a fault domain called Peterborough with hosts 4, 5, and 6. Okay, if you watch my demos, you'll kind of recognize that. But anyways, if you haven't, so let's go back to my VM, monitor, physical displacement. So let's go back to this. So right now, Web 1 is running on host 6. Hosts 4, 5, and 6 are in one location, okay? So we see we have our RAID 1 components on host 5 and 6, there's the two RAID 1s, and then we have a witness component on host 4. So that's in my Peterborough location. Then I'm mirroring that to my Toronto location. So there's host, there is the host 3, and 2 and 3 are hosting the mirror components, and then host 1 is the witness. So very similar to my diagram. And last but not least, you see over here, site A witness V class. That's the witness VM in a different location, let's say, all right? Running that witness component. Now, how do we look at votes? Let's minimize. There's a couple of ways to do this. The way I know, I'm going to go in my vCenter server, launch the Ruby vCenter console. You could also do it from the ESX CLI command, but I suck at that. So let me just log in as root. So at least you see me doing this. I've done this Ruby vCenter console in other videos, but at least give you a chance to see this. Let me change my font here, folks, because I always like to do that. Change settings. Let's go appearance. Let's go with a little bit bigger font. And I'm going to change the background color because I always like to do that. Modify, and we'll pick that. Looks good. Apply. There we go. Let's get that nice and big here. So I've SSH'd into my vCenter server, so I have that enabled. So I'm going to log into my Ruby vCenter console. So I'm going to say RVC, Ruby vCenter console, administrator at vSphere.local, and that's I'm connecting to this vCenter server. So this will be localhost. Hit enter, and then it's asking me for the password for that account, and then away we go. So what I want to do is look at the information for the VM. So I'm going to change into my local host, which is CD into zero. I'll do ls CD1. I'll go into my data center, so I'll change into zero. From there, I'll see all my, number four is my VM, so I'll change into that. I did a video on Ruby vCenter console if you want to check that out. If I do an ls here, you'll see that web one is number two, okay? So let me type in vsan dot, I always forget, so you can hit type in vsan, then tab, and way over here on the far right is vm object info, so vm underscore object info, and then I'm going to, vm web is number two, so I'm gonna say two, and it's bringing in the information on that. Okay, so great, here we go. So again here, just like I showed you in the GUI, you can see the home directory objects, you see the home object, you see the VMDKs, and you see the virtual machine swap files that's powered on. So at the bottom here, we see this is all the stuff for the virtual machine swap file. I'm going to ignore that. If I scroll up, you'll see, again, here's the stuff for the home. See, it says VMX there. So that's basically the components that make up the home. Let's ignore that. Let's look at the VMDK. Let me scroll down just a bit here. So it's right here. There's the VMDK. We'll see that it's running on host 6. We see the first RAID 1 component. We see component is running on host 5. And it's active. You see right here it says active. It's running on host 5. And then the other component is active. It's running on host 6, just like we saw in the GUI. But more importantly, notice the votes. It's got one vote on the host 5, one vote on host 6. When we look at the other RAID 1 component, we see it's active. And it's on host 3. And then the other one is active, it's on host 2. And again, more importantly, you see each have a vote of 1. Then we see our witness component. So you see the main witness, there's my witness VM. Okay, notice it's got votes of 3. Your vote numbers may slightly differ, especially if you're doing something like RAID 5. But anyways, and then over here, you'll see the other witness on host 4. It's got a vote of 1, and the other witness on host 1 has a vote of 1 as well. So we see that's basically like in the GUI. So let's go back to my iPad. So everything is fine. Now, what happens if I fail something? Well, if I lose my whole site, well, technically speaking, if I lost my whole site, here's this site is all gone. This VM is no longer running because it's on that site. So HA's got to kick in, right, folks? But I got 1, 2, 3, 6 votes still. So it will still work. No problems. All right? So let's see what happens. If I fail that site, what's going to happen? Just like I said, that VM is going to fail. vSphere HA is going to be kick in. Hopefully you have that enabled. And it's going to restart that VM on one of the surviving hosts in site 1. But notice what it's going to do. Notice the number of votes is now going to change. This is where adaptive quorum kicks in. Notice each one of these should get 3, 3, and 3 votes. And notice the witness over here will have 1 before it had 3. Okay? So let's try that out. I'm going to actually fail that, and I'll fail my host, and I'll come right back. Okay? So we'll see you back in 2 seconds. Okay, I'm back. Let's go back to the vSphere environment. You'll see I failed my host. Again, if you're familiar with my lab environment, I'm just using VMware Workstation, so I've just basically suspended those hosts. So you'll see here, hosts 4, 5, and 6 are no longer available. That's my site, right? That's my second site. Web 1 is running, but now notice it's running on host 3. It used to be running on host 6. So my site with hosts 3, 4, 5, and 6 failed. Web 1 was running on host 6, so that site failed. HA kicked in, restarted Web 1 back on host 3 over here, okay? Notice hosts 1, 2, and 3 are okay still. Let's go back into here, and let's just clear this up a bit. And let's take a look at now what we got. So here's my swap information. I'm just going to ignore that for now. Here's my VMDK. You'll see host 3 owns the VM. Our first RAID 1 component is absent. And that component is stale now because it's absent. And there's the host, the UID of it. The other component is absent as well. And there's its host. Now, when we look at the other RAID 1, so that's our 2 RAID 1s that were at the other site. Then we look at the other site here. We got our 2 RAID 1s. Notice it's active. And it's host 3. And it has 3 votes now. And we have host 2. And it has 3 votes. So now, remember, on my other site, I had to the host with the other 2 RAID 1 components. When we look at the witness, we see our site, the one at site 1, host 1, has a witness, and that has 3 votes. And then we have our main witness has 1 vote. So basically on my site, see the 3 votes here, 3 votes here, and 3 votes here. So my site 1 now has 2 components in the witness. It always had that. But now the votes are 3, 3, and 3. And then the witness over here has 1. It's changed. So what it's done, it says, hey, you know what? We lost site 2. Okay, right? We have enough resources to restart the VM. So it did that. Then vSAN said, you know what? I know we can make things a little bit better so we can withstand another failure. So it recalculated the votes to be able to do this, right? So now I got 3, 3, and 3 at site one, which is 9. And I got 1 for the witness. So let's go back to my iPad. So my iPad, and that's basically what I'm showing you here. So my VM is now over here, and I've got 3, 3, and 3. All right. What happens if I lose my witness? Well, in this example, let's do that. Nothing should happen, right? We lost our witness. This VM is on site one, should still continue to function because we still got 3, 3, and 3 votes here. We don't need to restart the VM. It's okay, all right? So let's go back and let me kill. I'll show you what I'm going to do here. The witness is running on host 7, so I'm just going to pause host 7. Okay, so let's go back into here. I killed host 7. All I did is pause it again. Just if I go into my VMware workstation, you'll see I'm just pausing these things, suspending them to memory, right? Anyways, so you'll see my witness is gone. My host 7 is gone. The VM is still running. If you don't believe me, let me just fire up the console. And again, I can log into it if I wanted to. No problems. It's working still, right? Let's look at the Ruby vSphere console. Let's look at the objects now. So again, here's my swap. Okay, great. Let's look at this one here. There's my VMDK. Again, we know the other site's gone. I've already shown you that. Here is my site one here, host 3. Still has 3 components. It's active. Host 2. Again, it's active. It has 3 components. 3 votes. And 3 votes for host 3. Sorry about that. Then we have our witness component is on host 1. It's active and has 3 votes. So again, site 1 has 2 components and a witness. 3 votes. Nothing's really changed, right? What did I do? I just killed the main witness, right? And you'll see it's absent here. The witness is absent. And it's still functioning, okay? So now, wonder what would happen if I did something like this. Let's go back to the iPad. What happens if the host that this VM is running on, in our lab, in my demo, I think it's host 3. But what happens if I kill the VM, or the host that this VM is running on? So if I kill this host, right, what's left? We got this component and we have this witness here. But we got 3 votes and 3 votes, a total of 6, right? We had 10, we have more than half, we have quorum. This thing should fail over to another host. So let's try that out, okay? Let me go back to my screen here. Okay, so right now, web 1 is running on host 3 over here on the far right. It's running on host 3. Let me go to host 3. And I'm not going to suspend it. Let's go into host 3. I could hit the power button if I want to. I'm just going to disconnect all the network cards from it. So it's like me walking up to a physical server right now and unplugging all the network cables. Don't do that in production. That would be a very bad move for your career. All right. So there we go. That's good enough. So I just done that. And it should take a few minutes for it to kick in. So I'll probably pause this recording until it does kick in. Okay, we're back. We see host 3 has disappeared. Now, if I look at web 1, it's now running host 1 over here, right? Basically, it HA kicked in, tried to shut it down, whatever, but it restarted back on host 1. Let's go back into my console and let's launch the web console. There we go. And again, you'll notice I have to log back in again because it had to reboot. So again, it's up and running. So what did we lose? We lost a whole site. We lost a witness. We lost a host, and it was still functioning, okay? So this is the advantage of stretch cluster with adaptive quorum. Now, there's one thing you got to be aware of, or two things, to be honest with you. These things cannot happen all at the same time. If site 2 went down, the witness went down, and my other host went down all at the same time, nothing, it won't work. It takes time because it would be considered a multiple failures. So site 2 went down, the witness was still there, and it says, oh, okay, site 2 is gone, let's adjust our new votes now. Okay, so if site 2 went down and the witness went down at the same time, well, if I go back to my screen here, let's go back to the iPad, go back to the original state. We had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 votes, and this had 6. 3 over here, it's a total of 9. If this died and this died all at the same time, we only got a total of 3 votes here out of 9. It won't power, it will not fail over. Okay? So it cannot happen at the same time. There's another situation that I've noticed. In order for this to work, notice my example was I killed site 2 first, then adaptive quorum kicked in, right? If I killed the witness, what happens? If I kill the witness first, what happens? So let me put everything back the way it was, and let's see what happens from there, okay? So I'll be right back. Okay, so we're back. I put everything back the way it was. Let's go back to my environment here. So web one is now running on, web one is now running back on host 6. I moved it over. Everything's up, okay? Let's go back to my RubyVisor console. Let me just clear this a bit. And again, you'll notice, again, let's just look at the VMDK information here, right? You'll see, again, remember, my web is running my second site. So you'll see you've got a RAID 1 component is active. It's on host 5. Another RAID 1 component's active. It's on host 6. Notice it's got a vote of 1 and a vote of 1. Then when that's on the second site. If I go to here, you'll see my host 4 on the second site is it's a witness component, and it's got a vote of 1. Then on my primary site, I got my host 3, which has a component, and host 2, which has a component. Both are active. Those are the RAID 1 components on my first site. And again, they each have 1 vote each. And last but not least, again, we see the witness on the first site right here. It's active, and it's on host 1, and it's got 1 vote. So everything went back to my diagram as before, and the main witness for the sites has 3 votes. Let's kill the witness, and let's see if everything gets readjusted. Okay, so let's go back in, and I'm going to go to my thing here. Let's go to host 7. Goodbye, host 7. Let's just hit that pause button. Oh, there we go. All right, so this will take a few minutes, so I'll probably stop the recording. We'll come right back. Okay, so we are back. My witness is gone. I let this run for a few minutes, at least 5 minutes. I went and grabbed the beer. If I go back into here, monitor physical displacement, you'll see the main witness, site A witness, is gone, but all the other stuff is there. If we go back to look at the objects again, let's just look at the VMDK. We still see we have an active object here and another active object on this host, and again with votes of 1 each. Again, my other site, we have an active object here and another active object here, each with a vote of 1, just like I showed you in my picture, right? The witness is gone. The main witness is gone, and it had 3 votes. And again, notice it says absent. It had 3 votes. The other witnesses that are on each site are still around. They have 1 vote each. So if I go back to my iPad, so we have 3 votes up here. We got 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. This guy's gone. Now, what would happen if I kill this site? So I got 3 votes is gone. I have total of 6 remaining. If I kill this, that would be 3 votes is gone. I got 3 remaining. That's not enough. This shouldn't fail over. Let's see what happens. Let's go back to my iPad. I may as well bring it along with the journey there. So let me go to host. Actually, let me just confirm. Web 1 is currently on host 6. Web 1 is currently on host 6. All right. So let's go in and kill all that. Just so it doesn't interfere with this, I'm just going to kill the network cards. Killing host 6. killing host 4. So I'm just going to simulate the whole site going down. That's host 4 and then host 5. I could have paused it, I guess. There we go. Okay, so let's go back to here and let's give it a few minutes. So I'll pause the recording. We'll be right back. Okay, we're back. We can see that I let this thing sit for 10 minutes. We can see web one is not coming back. All right. Everything is down. If I go back into, so my web one is see, it's disconnected. It's not coming back. If I go back into the Ruby vSAN console, let me just clear all this. And let me just scroll up so you can see a little bit better. So again, down here is the swap. I'm just ignoring that for now. Let me scroll back up. Here's the VMDK. You see we have various absent components. We have an active component, which is host 3. It has one vote. We have an active component, which is host 2. It only has one vote. Our witness is absent. That had 3 votes. That's gone. Here's the other witness that was before. And then we have our active witness. There's a witness here. It's active on host 1, but only has 1 vote. We only have 3 votes. That's less than quorum. We don't have quorum here. So what did we kind of learn from this? Now, this was with update 1. I haven't tried any other latest updates to see this, but it looks like the witness component is the one that kind of makes this decision here. Just my initial thoughts. So it depends on the order of when these things fail. We've seen that we had site 1 complete, sorry, 2 completely die. The witness was still alive, and we did the adaptive quorum. We adjusted everything. So this is going to depend on multiple devices not failing at the same time, which I mentioned before. If you lose a whole site and you lose a witness, you're dead in the water. So it seems to depend on the order of operations on what's going on here. Now, this, you're having a pretty bad day if something like this is happening, okay? But that's it, folks. Hey, I hope you found this beneficial. For those of you that have vSAN, leave your comments and questions down below. Let me know if you've run into this or if you've seen anything different. That would be very interesting. I haven't tried the latest updates and stuff like that. Hey, subscribe to the channel if this is stuff you're interested in. That's the one way to support the channel. It's free to do that. And share and like, please. And that's it. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.